many of us, Google is a lifeline. Anytime we have a question, we log on, type in a few words, and voila. But are you really getting the answers you're looking for, or are you being force-fed advertising without your knowledge? Larry Fiorino from G1440 joins us this morning with more. Larry, good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, the thing at issue here, they're called pay-for-click ads. What does that mean?
Well, they're ads that where Google makes money if you click on the ad. So it's called a pay-per-click. So if I click through, Google makes money. Basically, what they're doing is you can sign up and buy words, you know, because all the searches are done on words, right? Keywords. So you can buy a word from Google. You can say, I'm willing to pay up to $2 for this word. And what that means then is that every time somebody searches on that word, my ad will come up in the search return.
Okay. Now, on this surface, are we talking about the things on the right side of the screen, the far
right? The right side, and sometimes at the top.
Oh, that's true. I have seen those at the top now.
Right.
All right, now on the surface, people are saying, okay, if they want to pay for it, no big deal. But there is a problem here.
Right, and the rub is that competitors are buying the names of their companies they compete with. So let's say that I'm company A and I compete with company B.
Mm-hmm.
I'll buy company B's name as a keyword search.
Right.
Right?
Uh-huh.
So then when somebody searches on my competitor, they're going to get my ad.
Now, a lot of this stuff is trademarked, so is it legal for them to be, like, selling the name?
Well, there are several cases in court right now to decide just that. When is the proper use of the name? You know, I personally don't think it should be legal that if I've spent a lot of money branding and I'm advertising G1440, for example, if somebody searches on that, I don't want my competitor's ad coming up. And to make it even worse, now some companies are having to outbid the competitor for their own name.
Wow.
Because if I'm A and you're B and you buy my name for these pay-per-click ads, then what happens is somebody searches your ad comes up first.
Well, here's a question that I have. I see the ads, but I know they're ads. So if I'm searching for something, I skip them and I go down to the things that I believe are the real hits.
Right.
Not necessarily the ads. Is there any research on how many people go to those ads and think that they are the real results?
Google makes a ton of money on these ads.
Okay, so people are clicking them.
But you've hit the nail on the head. I think from a legal test, and I'm not a lawyer, but I think the test is really going to be confusion. Is it likely to cause confusion in a marketplace? That's the whole thing around trademarks.
All right, so can you protect yourself if you own a company and you think somebody's doing this to you?
Well, I can tell you what we do at G1440. Uh-huh. At least once a month, we go to all the search engines and we type in our brands.
Okay.
G1440, Builder 1440. We type in those and we see what ads come up.
And have you found that somebody's
used
your
name
before?
We have found our competitors have been doing this.
Really?
But we've written them nice letters telling them to stop, and they have.
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's not that easy, though.
Right. Right. And I think that's where Firepond is one of the lawsuits that was just filed in the last 2 weeks. That's an organization where their competitor is not willing to stop.
Wow. All right, Larry, we've run out of time. Very interesting.
It's fascinating.
Thank you so much. Well, how would you like to earn $500? You can whenever you refer an experienced computer programmer, developer, or other IT professional to G1440. Send their contact information to Larry@G1440.com. Full details of the program are online at G1440.com. Coming up in our 7 o'clock hour, it could be the missing link. Why scientists think an ancient fossil could be one of the first humans.
And explosive arguments surrounding a natural gas plant here in Baltimore County. I'm Megan Gillen. What residents here in Sparrows Point plan to do about it today, straight ahead. You're watching Fox 45 Morning News, all local, all morning.